This is the COS Lewis structure, carbonyl sulfide. For carbonyl sulfide, we have 4 plus 6 plus 6 valence electrons for a total of 16 valence electrons for the COS molecule. Carbon is the least electronegative. That'll go at the center, and we'll put the oxygen on one side and the sulfur on the other. We'll start by putting 2 electrons between atoms to form chemical bonds. Then we'll go around the outside. We've used 2, 4, 6, and 16 valence electrons. So we've used all 16 of the valence electrons we started with. This sulfur here has 8, so it has an octet, and the oxygen has 8. It has an octet. However, the carbon in the center only has 4 valence electrons, so it doesn't have an octet. To solve this problem, we can take 2 valence electrons here from the sulfur and move them inside to form a double bond. We're still using 16 valence electrons, but now we have 8 valence electrons here on the sulfur, and the carbon has 6, so we're getting closer. Let's share these two here from the oxygen with the carbon. So now, by sharing, we have 8 on the oxygen and 8 on the central carbon. Sulfur still has 8, and we're only using 16 valence electrons. That makes this the Lewis structure for COS. You might ask why I didn't form a triple bond between the oxygen and carbon or a sulfur and carbon. The reason is that oxygen and sulfur don't normally form triple bonds, and if I did that and checked my formal charges, I'd find that my formal charges would be +1 and -1 on the oxygen and sulfur. So that wouldn't be the best Lewis structure for COS. Formal charges should be as close to 0 as possible. In the case with this structure here, they're all 0 for each of the atoms. This is Dr. B with the Lewis structure for COS. Thanks for watching.